Hey guys, hope you had a fantastic new year. My name is Dylan, and today we're going to go over three custom keyboard shortcuts that will make your life editing a lot easier. They've made my life editing so much smoother when I hop into Final Cut, and I'm hoping they'll do the same for you.
Enough beating around the bush, let's take a look at the first keyboard shortcut that I've set up. You may or may not have seen or used this button. This is the button to solo a selected item. Basically, it mutes everything except that clip that you've selected. This is extremely helpful to do things like fine-tune your audio. For example, you can quickly isolate a clip or a sound effect on your timeline with this feature and make adjustments to it without hearing any of the other audio on the timeline. It also helps me to line up specific sound effects like whooshes and risers to the exact point I need them to play in the video. I use this feature for this reason pretty much every single time I edit. The default keyboard shortcut for this button is Option S, but I have mapped mine to a single key, which has saved me a lot of time. It is now the C key. All I have to do is press C and it solos the clip for me. Why do I like this? For one, it's right next to the shortcut to mute a clip, which is V. So it just makes sense since they're right next to each other. They're basically opposites. So I can just press V to mute and then C to isolate. At the end of the video, I'll show you how to map this to the C key, but for now, let's move on to the next keyboard shortcut. For those that frequently use clips shot in a higher frame rate for some slow motion, I've mapped automatic speed, which slows down your clip to fit your project frame rate, to Option Backslash. This is nice because anytime I have some clips I need to slow down, I just select them and hit Option Backslash and it'll slow them down for me. I don't have to enter this speed retiming menu at all, which saves me some time. The last thing I've done to my shortcuts is swap the blade tool, which was B, and the blade or cut action, which is Command B. So now I can quickly hit the B key to make a cut, which is so much easier than finding the Command key and then hitting B. It just makes sense to have it on one button. Once again, this may seem like a small change, but it really has made editing so much smoother for me. Here's how you can set these up. Press Option Command K, and this brings up your custom keyboard shortcut editor. I already created a custom keyboard here, but what you'll do if you haven't is press Duplicate and enter the name you'd like. So let's first do the solo clip button. I'll search the action in the search bar, select it, and then select the C key by hitting that key on my keyboard, and then press Reassign. You can map Option S to what you'd like now, you can leave it as is so you'd have two shortcuts with the same action, or you can just delete it like I've done here. Next, let's search Automatic Speed. You'll notice that this has no keyboard shortcut assigned to it. So once again, select it, press Option Backslash, or you can do Option S if you think you'd remember that more. And that's it, you don't have to press reassign for this button because there was nothing assigned to it in the first place. Last but not least, we have the swapping of the blade tool and blade. So search blade, make blade B by pressing that B key and then hitting reassign. Delete the default next. And for the blade tool, select it and hit Command B. Then hit save.
I swear by this setup, and I'm hoping it'll make your life editing as smooth as it has made mine. If you are wanting to learn about a key that can help you master the magnetic timeline, hit this video here, and I will see you guys next time.